Walking pneumonia cases have blown up among Queensland children. Thousands of infections already recorded before the typical peak of the season. The outbreak coincides with a shortage of antibiotics, not expected to be restocked by the end of winter.
When Year 5 student Olivia Badke came down with a runny nose and a cough, Mum Michelle didn't think much of it at first.
When I was, like, doing sport, it was just, like, getting harder to breathe.
As soon as I saw the rash, I thought that's time goes to the doctor.
Olivia, one of thousands of Queensland children diagnosed this year with mycoplasma pneumoniae, also known as walking pneumonia, because many sufferers are not so sick that they stay home, instead walking around and spreading the lung infection.
A couple of my friends had it.
Anecdotally, lots of people saying, oh, this is the sickest my child's been in some time, and a lot of that has been due to mycoplasma.
PCR testing numbers released by Sullivan Nicolaides Pathology showing they've picked up nearly 20,000 positive cases, up from just 443 in all of last year, the vast majority in children. More than 5,300 recorded among 5 to 9-year-olds, and nearly half of 10 to 14-year-olds tested returning positive results. Doctors reporting an increase in hospitalisations too for what's normally a mild infection.
Really high numbers of people in hospital and in intensive care units.
Each additional respiratory infection can potentially add more pressures onto our healthcare system.
Our hospitals are ready to deal with that demand.
The unprecedented surge in cases is so great, it's leading to a shortage of antibiotics, the children's version of azithromycin proving difficult to find.
It's been a couple of months and we expect it's going to last a few more months yet.
We just didn't know we'd need to have this many doses available.
This is the first time she's had to have a tablet.
For children not yet able to swallow tablets, an adult version of the drug can still be used, but it takes a bit of work to get the dosage right.
Crushing it up and suspending it in a liquid and giving a small dose of that.
Claire Todd-Hunter, Nine News.